Hey, what's up Blender users, I'm Jonathan, and in today's video, we'll go over a simple blood effect you can create in Blender. Blood spreading through fabric is just one of many different blood effects, so I might do some follow-up videos for blood hits and more. Oh, and by the way, if you enjoy my content, consider subscribing because I upload a new video every Saturday. And with that said, let's get straight into the video. First of all, we need to create a simple blood material that we can later apply to our shirt or background or whatever you like. So let's start Blender and add in a plane. I always start with a simple plane because this way I have all the freedom I need. I will give this plane a new material and choose Alpha Blend for the blend mode. This will come in handy later because the blood will have a transparent outline. Now let's go over to Cycles. Because we may want to visualize our material in this render engine. But personally, I like to work in material preview mode. This way I can make sure this material also works with Eevee. I won't go over the complete material setup, because you can download a blend file in the video description, including this blood material. But basically, I started with a gradient texture, and using the object UV coordinates and the quadratic sphere preset, we can easily create the circle. Using the scale operation in the vector math node, we can scale the circle, and by mixing this vector with a noise texture, we can add some variation. I also used some procedural textures from Simon Thomas to create this fabric look on the outside of our blood. This will just make it a lot more believable when it is spreading through the fabric. You can of course adjust the normals right here. I'm right now just using a procedural texture. But if you have fabric as your background, you might want to use its normal map in your blood. Now by the way, this is the complete texture setup. It is very messy, but basically I just animated this scale parameter for the initial movement, and because I wanted this fabric look on the outside to not continue to the very end, I used this value node to make this outside circle, which includes the fabric texture, smaller. So it ends up looking like this. But again, you can download this material in the video description. Right now, there are two ways for us to use this blood material. We can either use it with real video footage and somehow track it on a t-shirt, or use it together with a 3D character on a 3D generated t-shirt. And this is what we're gonna do in this tutorial. If you want to track it to deforming cloth as a VFX shot, I can recommend you this tutorial by CG Meta. By using this, this shouldn't be a big issue. So now let's create a quick and dirty t-shirt and apply this blood effect. Let's open a new Blender scene, and for the t-shirt I'll be using Make Human. This way we can easily select the torso and using the cloth brush create a simple t-shirt. So let's create a character you like and export it. Once your character is in your 3D scene, we can basically clean it up, so we won't need the eyes, which Make Human always exports, and the scale is way out of hand, so let's scale this one down to a more realistic size. Okay, how do we create a t-shirt from this model? This is relatively easy. We can just go into wireframe mode and select the torso. And now let's quickly clean up our selection. And once you have your selection ready, you can press P and separate it by selection. And we can just delete everything else. Now we have our t-shirt, but you can see right here, this is topology we don't need for a t-shirt. So let's clean this up, delete these faces, and just select this loop and search for grid fill. Just like this, and slide the vertices back into place. Now we can give this t-shirt some subdivisions using the multi-resolution modifier, and using the smooth and flatten brush, clean the rest of it up. Now this right now looks more like a human, so let's select the cloth brush, disable symmetry, and add in some wrinkles. Just like this. And now we have a quick and dirty t-shirt. To now apply the blood, we can just append our blood material, select our t-shirt and apply it to it. In the material preview mode, you can see that nothing really is happening because we are on frame 1, which means the blood will not really show up. So let's go to a later frame and you can see that still we cannot see anything. So let's adjust the UV coordinates. First of all, let's plug in UV coordinates. Now you can see something really strange is happening, so let's just reload it and you can see right here our blood starts to appear. But it looks really bad, so let's go into front mode and now select our mesh and press project from view. This way we get this effect, which is more believable, but still the orientation isn't right. So let's again select our mesh in edit mode and go into the UV editor and move the UVs to a spot where you like the blood to appear. For example, just right here. Now, of course, the rest of the shirt is transparent, and we can easily change this by plugging in a different shader into this shader input. So let's just use a diffuse one and see if this works correctly. Now, this doesn't look really correct, and this is because we have the show back face option enabled. So let's disable this one, and you can see that now we have a believable t-shirt with blood spreading on it. Now you can of course stop at any time by animating these options, but for me I will just stop the render, maybe right here. To now add a texture to the rest of the t-shirt, we can just delete the test diffuse shader and add in a principled BSDF one, connect it to the mix shader, and with Node Wrangler enabled, you can just press Ctrl, Shift and T and select a fabric texture. Now we might need to adjust the scale, so I suggest you to use different UV coordinates for the t-shirt and for our blood. So let's adjust the scale to a scale we like. And now, because I was previewing only the principled BSDF shader, let's preview it together with our blood. And you can see that this works perfectly. As I told you before, we can now use different normals for the blood, so it looks better together with our background fabric. And now we have a pretty realistic blood spreading effect in our 3D scene. And yeah, this is basically it. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, consider liking and subscribing. And we'll see you in the next video, next Saturday.